Hi, it's Steve here. I'm going to show you in this video how to create a website and share it with your students. You can use the website to deliver instructions, resources, or options to your kids. To start with, go to a web browser and go to the website education.weebly.com. Just type that in, education.weebly.com. Then come up with a username, a password, make a note of your password somewhere, type in your email address and click on I accept, and then click on sign up. Once you have an account with Weebly, you can sign in, and you may come to this dashboard where you can add a site up here. But the first time you log into Weebly, I think it will automatically take you into this screen anyway. And this is the screen that you will find yourself in where you create a website. It says choose a theme up the top. Now you really can change this theme later. So you can click any of these for now and you can come back and change the way it looks. I'm going to click on that first one up the top left there. I'm going to click on choose. This window appears and it's basically wanting to know where the people in the world go to get to your website. What's the website address going to be? You will probably want to click up the top here and type in a web address here. Now, if I type in address like cats.weebly.com, someone in the world has already chosen that website address. So I will need to change it. You might make it year 9 history. That's been taken. Okay, so you might say, we don't want it too long, so you might type in year 9 hist. That's available. year9hist.weebly.com. You don't need to worry about these two options there. So just that top option, type in a web address and click on continue. Okay, this is what your website currently looks like, and you can make as many changes as you want on this screen. But up the top here where it says publish, that's what you click when you want the changes that you've made to actually go live on the web. I can actually click publish right now if I want. I'm going to do that right now. Even though there's nothing on my website, I'm going to click on publish. And lo and behold, this same screen pops up again. Because we can actually change that, but we're quite happy for that to stay as it is. year9hist.weebly.com. So I'm just going to click continue again. And it wants me to categorize my website. And I'm just going to call it education. Gee, it wants another category. I'll just call it teacher. I'm going to say, don't ask me this again, and click on continue. It's now publishing my website. Now, I have a bit of a tip for you now. See, it says website published. What I recommend you do here is right click on this link and click on open in a new tab, and you'll see up the top of my screen there it's opened it up in a new window. The reason I've done that is that means I can continue to make changes in this window and then just pop over to that other window when I want to see the actual live website. Notice here as well that Weebly is trying to upsell me. It's saying, good news, year9hist.com is also available. So it's trying to sell me a .com address. But if I click on continue down there, it's going to try to charge me money to get my own .com. I don't want that. So I'm just going to close that. I'll just show you what happens again if I click on publish. I click on publish. The website address pops up. There we go, http. p.year9hist.weebly.com. I can open that in a new tab, and it pops up the top there, and then it tries to upsell me, and I can just ignore that. I really don't have to click on any of this. I can just close that. Now, I'll go over to this tab up the top here, and yeah, that is my website. The whole world can now see that website. Year9hist.weebly.com is now live to the world. Back here, I'm going to begin creating. First of all, I'm going to type up here, and I'm going to change it to Year 9 History. That's the name of my website. And then I'm going to get rid of this picture here by clicking on the picture, and then clicking on the picture of the cog, and saying no header. I don't want a header. Okay, now I've created a bit more space.